This is the only way that you can preserve confidence.
Sure, I don't have any data to say that this is a standard.
Dr. Mustafa, you ask about the divorce.
Yes.
But I didn't believe in this divorce because you ask the divorce just only difference in the anatomy. But if we look into the molecular biology, which is very important, do you have difference in the molecular biology between the upper to third and the lower third? No. The same genetic disease of the colorectal carcinoma as regarded the microsatellite, the PRF, the KRAS, the NRAS, there is no difference in the molecular biology between the upper to third and the lower third. So I am not totally agree about the divorce. Just only you have a difference in the anatomy.
So it's not usually, you don't have to take the decision only for the biology of the disease. Sometimes you need to define it as a functional outcome or the treatment results. If you looked at the GE junction, for example, you have the CWRT classification, type 1, type 2, type 3. If you went down toward the stomach, if you went down to the stomach, you classify it as CWRT type 3 and consider it as gastric junction. Although the AGCC7, this AGCC7, it tells us that if the tumor extending up to the esophagus, consider it as esophagus, especially if it is undifferentiated or squamous cell carcinoma. So I mean, it's just
the upper one, which is related to peritoneal reflection.
We do peritoneal reflection. No, I'm just talking about another example.
Sigmoid, no, to separate the sigmoid from the rectum.
Let me continue. I'm just talking about another way of classifying things, just for the site.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. Although biologically it's totally different,
the stomach
is totally different than the esophagus.
Thank you for a great presentation. Obviously, the discussion indicates that you're kind of innovative, and that's to your credit. But there are four principles in rectal surgery, rectal cancer operation. Number one, oncological outcome, preserving patient life, is much more important than preserving an organ, because seriously, this is the goal of the treatment. Number two, abdominal colostomy is better than perineal colostomy. Number three, when we operate for rectal cancer and we have complete pathological response, the issue is not the local disappearance of tumor, because we know T3, T4 tumor has very high rate of lymph node metastasis. And even with complete pathological response on the tumor and the rectum, the lymph nodes are not clear. So you're still going to have a positive disease. So you cannot leave these tumors unresected. However, in the United States and Memorial, there's a protocol where actually it was by default where a patient who had this rectal cancer treated with neoadjuvant chemoradiation and then complete pathological response, and the patient says, no, I don't want to have an operation. So they followed this patient up.
It's good.
So it's actually been happening. So your idea is not, it's innovative and it's not new, it's being done. But the issue is we cannot have a randomized trial, because it would be very unethical to randomize patient to no surgery versus observation, because you know the risk of local recurrence, the salvage APR is very small, and the patient most often die from pain and miserable, they are very miserable and very poor quality of life. So I think, the approach, is kind of sounded innovative, but you're taking a great risk in gamble with the patient life as a local recurrence.
If we divide it in the staging system, in the classification, and then we started by recruiting patients, when we analyze the results.
What are the criteria you would randomize patient to no surgery if they have complete pathological response? Define the criteria, and you will find a lot of taker. The issue is, unless you have molecular profiling for these tumors to say, okay, if they are XYZ genes are expressed or not expressed, they would, likely to have complete pathological response. The lymph node basin is likely to be cleared. This is the patient that will be avoided from having a colostomy. I think this is the key question. Until we get to that point, the standard of care will still be surgery with clearance of the nodal basin. Thank you.
Professor Mittal-Hafeng.
I would like to add to Dr. Ahmed Abdelaziz, as regards the incontinence after anterior section. As he said, it is due to loss of the reservoir, rectal reservoir. And it occurs in 70 to 80% of cases. But you don't assess the incontinence except after 1 year from the operation. Because after 1 year, 99% of these patients will be continent. That's one thing. As regards CR, for chemoradiation, it is the same like a new adjuvant chemotherapy for breast cancer. You always find islets of cancer cells in the mid of these fibrous tissue. And even after you will get the specimen out, you may find that there is no tumor in the specimen, pathological. But this is false, because if you want to make pathological examination of a specimen of 2 to 3 centimeters, you have to have 20,000 sections to be sure that there is no, and it is not available at all.
بنشكركم جدا يا جماعه عشان الوقت، وبنشكرك يا دكتور مصطفى قوي على فتح باب مناقشه جميله زي كده، بس الموضوع برضه محتاج يعني كلام كتير قوي مش هنقدر نتكلم فيه دلوقتي.